Now, once again, the aircraft belonged to Genesis Helicopters and appeared to be on a tour over the Pearl Harbor area. Today, we did check with the Federal Aviation Administration to find out exactly what it knows about the company. We also checked with an aviation expert who talked about the crash itself. Bridget Namata goes beyond the headlines tonight with that part of the story. Bridget.
Yes, Dash, the FAA told me it started an open crash investigation to look into whether the tour helicopter was following rules and regulations before the crash.
When something goes wrong, aviation analyst Peter Forman says a pilot doesn't have much time to react.
Typically, at the altitude that helicopters cruise at, he's probably going to have less than a minute to put that thing on the ground, so he was a very busy guy.
FAA guidelines say tour helicopters must stay at 1,000 feet or below when entering Honolulu airspace.
If there is a power failure, all of the helicopter pilots are taught to auto-rotate. He's looking for a place to put the helicopter down, and he's coming down at a fairly good angle, so he doesn't have a lot of choices at that point.
I spoke to someone who personally knows a pilot who flew the helicopter that went down. He's also a pilot. He says he doesn't know exactly what happened, but he saw the video and thinks the helicopter suffered some sort of mechanical failure.
I stopped by Genesis Helicopters headquarters.
Hi, guys. Genesis. Are you here with Genesis?
But did not get a response. The FAA tells me it regularly inspects helicopter tour operators. Changes were made in 2007 after a string of helicopter crashes.
I think the reason we see so many here in Hawaii is because there are so many helicopters here. I mean, there is quite a thriving tour business with helicopters.
Some of those changes, helicopters that fly over water must install floats, better pre-flight passenger briefings, and life preservers.
Those are all factors in the investigation. I'll continue to follow this, and I'll keep you posted on what I find out. Bridget Namata, KHON 2 News.
Bridget, thank you. We're also told that for the time being, all operations at Pearl Harbor Visitor Center are on hold. Now, this includes visits to the USS Arizona Memorial itself. No visitors are being allowed in, and all the boat rides to the memorial have been canceled.
Due to all the emergency vehicles and what was happening, there were some street closures, and that caused us to have to close off entering the visitor center area.
Officials expect the closures to last a few days while the investigation is conducted.
And this is the third helicopter crash crews have had to respond to just this year. Last month, 12 Marines were killed when two CH-53 helicopters crashed in the waters off Oahu's North Shore during a pre-planned training mission. And also last month, a Blue Hawaiian helicopter made a hard landing at Kalalau Beach on Kauai's Napali coast. There were six passengers and one pilot on board. Some had minor injuries.
And again, we first told you about the chopper crash via a push alert, which sends breaking news directly to your phone. You can sign up for the alerts through our free KHON2 mobile app and stay with KHON2 on air and online. A very fluid situation still developing. We'll continue to bring you the latest updates on air and online about this crash.